Thank you, Engineer Jaruk. That's very confidence, the high confidence, and from a $5 billion worth industry to the Sri Lankan economy. Let's quickly move on to Engineer Manoj Pallavat on the education. And I do appeal to the listeners who have joined in to keep sending the questions. It's important. We'll try to do justice to as many questions as possible, yeah. But considering the time.
Hi, everyone. Subha Sandhyavak. I think the former gentleman who spoke on the lines, they were very emphatic on their particular areas of the SDGs. And now we were talking about the industry perspective on the sustainability, sustainable development, and connection with the engineering. So industry, in the topic that I have been given, is the education industry. And education itself is not contained here. It's the education as well as the profession. So I will quickly go into that particular area. So let's see, very common picture that you have all seen, the 17 SDG goals. And I was careful to pick up a few which are directly related to engineering. So you can see goal number 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11, 12, and 13, which are connected to engineering. And I will get down to the particular goals that are more important than the others, in my perspective, when it comes to engineering education. Okay, so let's get to the next step. So sustainability through education, engineering or otherwise, is dependent on the societal mindset. So I have seen, this had been my idea for a long time. Now this idea has really become some SDG goals. We are in a consumption-based society. We are consumers. But some time ago, our country especially, were conservation-based societies. It was the conservation that mattered. So now what we have to do is go from this consumption-based society to a conservation-based society. This is actually very aptly portrayed in the 12th SDG goal. And so what are the characteristics of our society now? Unfulfilled, craving for more, incessant competition, and also selfish with scant regard to the others and the environment, squandering non-renewable resources, short-sighted development and economic policies targeted on the present. So these are the characteristics of our society now. I think what we should go for is a conservation-based society which will give contented people with realistic aspirations who are concerned about the others and the environment as our ancestors, conserving the non-renewable resources, far-sighted development and economic policies with future generations in mind, and comprising of more physically and mentally healthy and happy people. So wouldn't this be the ideal society that we would crave for? So with that, I think we'll go into UN SDGs that are related to engineering education, because education itself under SDG 4 is pointed out, quality education. Now, engineering education is supposed to be quality education. And quality in what? Because it is dealing with development for the world and the people. I will elaborate on a particular aspect of this a little bit later, but here, now you can see these education goal is directly connected to the goal numbers 8, 9, 9 and 11, which are our former gentleman elaborated on several of these. And so decent work and economic growth, and industry innovation and manufacture infrastructure, as well as sustainable cities and communities, all sustainable. So education will, in other words, or in specific, engineering education in a proper sense will facilitate these three SDGs, which will in turn give you access to my or our final goal, responsible consumption and production. I think with all these goals in the SDGs, I feel we should concentrate on this particular goal. This is a very important goal as far as sustainability and the future progression of the humankind as well as any kind in this world is concerned. So then we'll come to our area. Today is the World Engineering Day. So I'm happy that I'm presenting here on behalf of engineers as well as behalf of engineering, because role of engineering, according to so many definitions, is the innovative use of planet's resources for the benefit of mankind. It is said that it's mankind. I'm asking why. Why mankind? Actually, I think, of course, the things have, the placements have gone out. Naturally, the technology is always against us when it comes to PowerPoint presentations and these things. So I will come to the point where who is an engineer? Now, engineering we know. And who is an engineer? And I have found out from few languages, including ours. In Sinhala, we said Mausuru, the person who creates. In Thai, they say Vishwakon. That means who does Vishwakarma things. That means very impressive things. In Latin, ingenuator, who's ingenious. And also, I found the Dutch word ingenieur also has been derived from Latin, I suppose. So all these things point out that an engineer, the mindset of an engineer, should be an innovator. A person who uses the forces of the nature, including material, energy, and all these things, for the benefit of the nature itself, not only for his own or her own benefit. So then now the definition I have tried to point to you is a person, engineer is a person who is capable of innovating planet's resources towards products and services for the mankind. Okay, again the mankind is there. So I will go to the next one to show you. This is a very important point I wish to bring to your attention today. Has engineering got sustainability building? Actually, if engineering is innovative use of planet's resources for the benefit of not mankind, I have stricken it off and put all living beings present and future, by changing the scope, I think engineering shall be wholly sustainable. So if we forget our old definition of the mankind only and expand it further, then we can get total sustainability into our noble profession of engineering. Okay, so with that, I come to a very controversial and so to say pointed area. Okay, sustainability has always been implied in engineering. We have analysis, design, and culmination. Culmination in so many ways, construction, development, all these things are the culmination of engineering. It has to be emphasized in the curricula. The curricula what we are talking about is not only in the university or higher educational or tertiary level education, but this has to be cultivated at the school education itself. So what came to the mind was good manners and ethics, religious, social and upbringing with empathy, and strongly rooted concepts on conservation. They should be built in not at the tertiary level, but at the school education itself. I think we are not very effective lately than earlier in doing this to our children. Then when it comes to tertiary education, the emphasis on conservation is in design at all levels. And green concepts have to be cultivated. I think this process have got grounding and it is floating or going ahead in the engineering curricula for some time now. But we still have to see the final effects of this. Right, then I will skip this because of the time limitations. This is about the point that I wanted to make was for sustainable development through engineering education, the education itself should be sustainable. So for that one, I have indicated that the different levels of engineering practitioners that are needed in a country for sustainable development of engineering itself has to be regulated. So that's why we need, we have global understandings on the competence levels needed and what the national economy can contribute to the engineering education and the outcomes of it. And the national industry development drive should always have total usage of these engineering products, that's engineering practitioners, because they should not be underutilized. So that is the point, I think, for sustainability that we need to achieve. So with that, I think I will skip this slide also. And thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for the opportunity given to me. So thank you.